But Bill McDonagh will come over and ask horse for him and here they are to prove it. Married him. Makes no difference. But still no unfaithful king and sovereign.
Big Joe was a leader of the Joyce family. He got the tape that Quinn McDonagh had made and sent back his reply.
James, I phoned you yesterday, giving you a day in April when I wanted to fight you. You told me that you were fighting no more and you called me an old man. I know old man James, the 10 years good fighting left in me yet. They'll be able to, I'll be waiting here, James, till I come 70 years of age, because you're no good. And there never was a man belong here, James, and never will be a man. I'm the legend, James, not you. You're not when you're body back and a good for nothing man.
Hello. He is here.
Who's that?
Hello.
Right, now listen. Get out of Kilbeggan here right away. Ditch is the green. For me to go out and watch in Kilbeggan. The video man is here. You go to Kilbeggan now. No more talking. He ain't beat me in Kilbeggan in half an hour. No, this won't go.
Up, Jace. The Jace is going to do today.
Up, Jace.
Down the name and up to Jace.
Up, Jace.
Yes.
And fuck up the name and down the Quinn. Fuck them.
The Quinn McDonaghs had told me about Big Joe Joyce. They said he was a wild man. He was one of the best-known bare-knuckle fighters in Ireland, but he hadn't had a fair fight for 10 years. That morning he was leading his men to fight against another traveller family called the Nevins. They met near a small town in the Midlands, but armed police had set up roadblocks to try to stop the fights.
5, 6, 7.
This was the scene on the outskirts of Longford town at 8 o'clock this morning. Acting on a tip-off, Gardaí engaged 200 officers, many of them armed, to effectively seal off an area where the so-called King of the Travellers bare-knuckle fight was due to be staged today.
What was to take place at Mullalher was that there was to be a contest between 12 males, and the winner was to be declared the King of the Travellers.
As it happened, the scheduled fight never took place, but the Gardaí say their actions were justified after the detection of a sawn-off shotgun on the site and the seizure of an array of farmyard implements. The Gardaí say the scale of their operation ensured there was no loss of life, but they've appealed to certain sections of the travelling community to turn away from violence.
I don't wear nothing on my hands, it's beer knuckles out when that's it like. No such thing as bandages. Because bandages kills a clout, you're not able to cut your man in or do nothing to him. So that's it. Bandages only for the ring, for the gloves, not for bare knuckles. When I used to be doing a lot of training years ago when I was a young lad, I used to, before I'd fight a man, maybe a month beforehand, he'd stick my hands in petrol. He'd lay my hands like a rock, rock hard. But I don't like telling that to everybody. Any young lad is going to there, like, I don't want everybody to know my secrets. But that was a secret of my hands, keeping them hard, keeping them like a stone. I used to have them. Lay them in petrol for 20 minutes every day. Any man I ever fight, he'd get, I always left him with a face like a butcher's block. I would lay him with 9 or 10 stitches, 20 stitches or something like that.
I'd seen James destroy Big Joe's younger brother Paddy in their fight. I wanted to find the right moment to ask Joe why there was so much hatred between the families.
Well, that horse, he's 2 year old and me. He's just been trained 3 weeks. He's a trotting colt. So I was seeing him quite like to have him ready for the summertime of the year for the drives. Hopefully in another couple of months he'll be doing about 27 or 28 miles an hour.
Come on.
Well, the reason why my brother Paddy fighted James Quinn. My brother Paddy is a class of a simple boy. We call him a simple boy. Like, he's not the full shilling. He looks the real thing, but he's not the real thing. He seen James Quinn fighting and he thought he could beat him. Which he made a mistake in that. He didn't. James Quinn beat him and
that was hit. But I still didn't leave James Quinn any good. Because he bet nobody, only a very bad man would have had it.
The reason I used to fight one time was the end of your man and Quinn to hurt them. Quinn and Layman in a hospital case. But the minute's going today, they're not fit to do this. The minute's going today, you won't, they'll barely come out with a black eye out of it. They're only pawing one another. I get that young lad there to hit harder. He's only 12 years old. They don't know how to fight. They know how to spar all right. They know how to dance around. They don't know how to win and hit. So I don't class them in back in Ireland any good today, George.
So I mean, forget about Baldy Jane. When Baldy Jane wouldn't fight a man at 50 years of age, a great grandfather, my brother Joe.
Six.
Hey, look it. Them is the men. Them is the men that you kill from behind. You cowardly pack of bollocks. Kiss my Joyce's horn. And then one more thing. If there's air of Quinn that'll match up to me, I will gladly fight him, and I gladly beat him. You dirty pack of cowardly murdering bastards. This is the real legend, James.
No, Pete, I'm good for nothing about you. I'm beating you, mate. That's it, I'm beating you. I'm supposed to fight in March. I wouldn't howl in March. We're both Paddy's fighting.
James was true to his word. He hadn't fought again, but he was now refereeing for other traveller families. Big Joe Joyce was coming out of retirement to fight against one of his other enemies, Annie McGinley. I'd now been recording these fights for 9 years, and here I was in the middle of a forest filming two grandfathers beating each other up. Bits of my footage had ended up on YouTube, but I didn't really care about that. Something about this fight made me want to quit. I was there because I was getting a thrill out of it. It wasn't really about making a film anymore. I decided to stop. No more fair fights. I kept the tape to myself and didn't show it to anyone.
Who won the fight? Still king, boy. Still king.